got my first real six string, bought it at the five and dime, played it till my fingers bled. Was the summer of 69.
The year was 1969. On July 20th, Neil Armstrong became the first man to walk on the moon. However, these times of success would not last long, as a recession hit the United States, started in December of 1969, only ending in November of 1970. However, this was only the beginning of the tragedies that would unfold upon the United States. On June 17th, 1972, our story begins in a series of events that would change the way that people look at the United States government.
President Nixon's approval ratings have dropped to 31%. In January, they were as high as 68%.
That's right. The nation seems to be rapidly losing confidence in its president in light of the recent
ongoing Watergate scandal. The Senate Select Committee on Presidential Campaign Activities, headed by Samuel Irwin Jr., has begun televised legal proceedings regarding the scandal. White House counsel John Dean has attested that the Watergate hotel break-in was approved by...
To continue to fight through the months ahead for my personal vindication would almost totally absorb the time and attention of both the President and the Congress in a period when our entire focus should be on the great issues of peace abroad and prosperity without inflation at home. Therefore, I shall resign the presidency effective at noon tomorrow. Vice President Ford will be sworn in as president at that hour in this office. As I recall the high hopes for America with which we began this second term, I feel a great sadness that I will not be here in this office working on your behalf to achieve those hopes in the next 2.5 years.
President, I must say, you're looking fresh today.
Well, thanks for appreciating the drip, boy. You're here earlier than usual.
Well, I thought you'd want to see this right away. This is the New York Times, sir.
What is this, the Pentagon Papers? Are they filling the tea about Vietnam?
If you don't need to stay, I'll be going, sir.
No. Go get me John, boy.
Right away, sir.
Have you seen this?
Just this morning.
What's our next move?
I've been talking to some of the boys, George and Howard, and they're cooking up a little something.
What kind of something?
Go. it's happening right now.
What's this?
They found this on Woody.
Yeah, so? It's only a rack or two.
Well, that was all they found on him. They found the rest in the Reserve Bank in Mexico. They'll know he had help.
Well, what do we do? Take this.
Go talk to Dick. I'll keep you in the loop, Dean.
Dean, please sit down.
Have you heard the news?
Yes. Mitchell and Ehrlichman told me. Do me a favor and give that money in your hand to the plumbers.
Right away, sir.
Listen, I really don't think that investigating this further is an option.
And what do you mean?
The CIA continues this investigation, the whole Bay of Pigs thing will be blown wide open.
Alright, sir, it'll be taken care of. It was just an accident. The president has essentially no involvement.
And how do we know that we can trust you?
The president believes that it will open up the whole Bay of Pigs thing again if you go any further in the case.
Alright, I'll talk with the higher-ups, and we will consider our disengagement from the case. Yeah, you'll get your money at the end of the week.
We better. You know, the only reason we're keeping quiet is because you're paying us some fat stacks. What is it, Dean? I'm a little busy.
Sir, there's a cancer on the presidency. If we don't stop it, it will all get taken down.
What are they gonna do? Fire me? I'll die before the day I come clean.
Sir, I don't want to take part in this anymore.
As you wish. Just don't be a rat.
Thank you for coming to see me.
My pleasure. Please set some ground rules, though. Do not quote me, not even anonymously.
Is that all? I can do that.
Well, that, and I can't tell you any new information, as it would be contrary to my responsibility as a loyal employee of the FBI to leak information. I can, however, confirm information that you already know.
All right. Well, if you don't mind, I have a few questions for you. Mr. Nixon, I have reason to believe that you were hiding something.
I have no idea what you mean.
I'm not dumb. I see that there is a surplus of tapes behind your back.
No.
You are obscuring justice by withholding evidence.
These tapes have nothing on them.
I already know that they have information regarding the scandal.
Okay. Fine. Here you go.
The rest of them?
What do you mean? That's all of them.
I can see that there are two behind your back.
No, these are my hands.
Just hand them over, man.
Now that we got the tapes from Mr. Nixon, we can finally move on to blowing this case wide open.
Alright, so where do I come in?
You play such an important role. The Select Committee on Presidential Campaign Activities has appointed you as Special Prosecutor for the hearings.
Great. I'm sure nothing bad will come of this. This is unacceptable. I know. I'll have him fired. Boy, go fetch me Richardson.
Order, sir. What seems to be the issue, Mr. President?
I need you to fire Cox.
No.
Ruckel's house, get in here.
Yes, Mr. President?
Fire Cox, right now.
No, sir, I refuse to do that.
Then you're fired. Mr. President, what's all the commotion about? Bork, I need you to fire Cox. I bet. Hello? Yes, this is Archibald Cox. Cox, President Nixon wanted me to tell you that you're fired. What?
What is it?
I've been fired from my position as Special Prosecutor.
Your Honor? Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, my name is Leon Jaworski, representing the prosecution in the case of United States versus Liddy. I come to you today as a representative of the United States, which has been wronged by the break-in and wiretapping that occurred at the Democratic National Committee headquarters at the Watergate Hotel. This case is brought under the Select Committee on Presidential Campaign Activities, which has deemed that the withholding of information contained within tapes held by President Nixon is unjust and an abuse of power. Using these tapes, as well as calling to the stand one witness of John Dean, we will attempt to prove if President Nixon was or was not involved in the break-in at the Watergate Hotel that took place on the morning of June 17th, 1972. The facts will show that on the morning of June 17th, 1972, five burglars were arrested after breaking into the Democratic National Committee headquarters at the Watergate Hotel. Tapes were withheld by President Nixon that involved information regarding the break-in, which we have for you all to analyze today. Based on the evidence that you will hear at the end of this trial, we will ask you to find President Nixon guilty of being involved with the aforementioned break-in.
Your Honor, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, my name is Gordon Liddy, representing the defendant in the case of the United States versus Liddy. I come to you today representing myself, Gordon Liddy, E. Howard Hunt, and James McCord, who have been accused of breaking into the Democratic National Committee headquarters at the Watergate Hotel on the morning of June 17, 1972. President Nixon's involvement in the break-in is also relevant. However, after seeing the evidence and hearing testimonies from two witnesses called to the stand, James McCord and E. Howard Hunt, we will ask you to return a verdict in favor of myself, Gordon Liddy.
Thank you, Your Honor. I call to the stand James McCord. Is it true that you were not at the Watergate Hotel on the morning of June 17th, 1972?
Yes, that is true.
Your Honor, I rest my case.
The prosecutor may cross-examine.
Is it true that you were, in fact, involved in the planning and execution of the break-in at the Watergate Hotel on the morning of June 17th, 1972?
It is not true, no.
Is that so? Well, the information on these tapes proves otherwise.
They suggest that you were, in fact, involved with the break-in, and as such, you are currently lying under oath.
What? No, those are fabricated. I swear, I had nothing.
Order in the court. The prosecution, I present the evidence to the jury.
Thank you, Your Honor.
As I've told you before, no one will know.
Know what?
That I was involved in the break-in, of course.
Me too? Me three? This is admissible in court. Good thing no one will find these tapes.
Defense, you may call your second witness to the stand.
Thank you, Your Honor. I call to the stand E. Howard Hunt.
Both the prosecution and the defense have now rested their cases. The attorneys will now present their final arguments. Please remember, what the attorneys say is not evidence. However, do listen closely. They are intended to aid you in understanding the case. Prosecution, you may begin.
Thank you, Your Honor. Members of the jury, today you have heard testimony about the break-in at the Democratic National Committee headquarters at the Watergate Hotel on the morning of June 17, 1972. I'd like to remind you of some important information that you should consider in your decision. These facts include the testimony of John Dean, as well as the information in the tapes that prove President Nixon's, James McCord's, and Gordon Liddy's involvement in the break-in. Please find the defendant guilty of charges of obstruction of justice, abuse of presidential powers, and hindrance of the impeachment process. Thank you.
Defense, you may proceed to your closing arguments.
Thank you, Your Honor. Members of the jury, today you have heard testimony about President Nixon's, Gordon Liddy's, and James McCord's involvements in the break-in at the Democratic National Committee headquarters at the Watergate Hotel on the morning of June 17, 1972. I would like to remind you of some important information that you should consider in your decision. These facts include McCord's testimony of not being at the Watergate Hotel on the morning of June 17, 1972.
Objection! Your Honor, if I may.
I don't think that's allowed.
The information received from McCord was found to be a lie, and thus it is not applicable.
Bro, let me speak.
As I was saying, please find our client, Gordon Liddy, not guilty. Thank you.
Members of the jury, you have heard all of the testimony concerning this case. It is now up to you to determine the facts. You and you alone are the judges of the fact. Have you reached a verdict?
We have, Your Honor.
What say you?
We, the jury, in the case of United States versus Liddy, find the defendant guilty of the charges of obstruction of justice, abuse of presidential powers, and hindrance of the impeachment process.
Thank you, jury, for your service today. Court is adjourned.
I don't know about all this Watergate business. I wish the kids would just stop watching these hearings all 24 hours of the day. I mean, come on, kids, play Pong. That just came out, looks real fun. That said, if these things are true about all that corruption business, well, I kind of thought there was something special about the presidents. Like maybe God had something to do with the things they did with his guiding hand. I don't like thinking that the President of the United States of America is just a man like me. That's why these hearings and trials are what have you are just a bunch of hogwash.
The hearings have stirred up so much paranoia. Today, everybody's a conspiracy theorist. There's no true Americans left in the government, they say. They're all corrupt, up to the highest in the land. It's the Red Scare all over again, I tell you.
This is incomparable to the Red Scare. Samuel Irvin Jr. cannot be compared to that scoundrel McCarthy.
I tell you, it's the exact same thing. History repeats itself, don't you know that? They're trying to get us to distrust everyone. That's what McCarthy did, and that's what's happening now. That's not how we should live.
McCarthy leveraged fear and rhetoric, but his words were empty. They didn't stand up to public scrutiny when televised. This Senate committee, on the other hand, uses evidence, actual evidence, a wealth of evidence, against Nixon and the others.
This is destroying my faith in America.
This is restoring my faith in America.
Seems like Nixon's been a bad boy.
So, what's next for us? I feel like things have cooled down.
We could retire.
We both know that's never gonna happen. It's been years. On to the new story. I'm gonna keep digging until I die.
Yeah, I know you. You know me. The movie, it went well, and I think you'll agree it brought about some change.
Yeah, no matter how many articles and novels we pump out, only Robert Redford can bring the real issues to the people, huh?
But we have to take some pride in the work we've done.
I'm not one for self-congratulation.
They just passed the Ethics in Government Act. You heard about that, of course.
Of course. Pretty much directly in response to Watergate. I'd say it's a step in the right direction for accountability in government.
Even going so far as to establish a new office, something about special counsel. This could bring about real change.
Yep, establishing an independent counsel to provide reports to Congress. It certainly appears to be a good measure in the process of preventing corruption.
They've got to keep up appearances.
And we need to keep tearing them down.
God bless America. So, what are you doing to address the public's concerns about government corruption?
Well, we're working on increasing transparency and accountability.
That's a load of nonsense. You politicians only care about lining your own pockets and serving your own interests. You don't care about the people you're serving.
That's simply not true. We're working hard to represent our constituents and improve their lives.
Oh, sure. Just like how you promised to fix our roads and bridges, and then just pocketed the money for yourself.
Is there any truth to these allegations?
Of course not. We have strict regulations in place that prevent the misuse of funds.
Like you politicians ever follow the rules. You're all just a bunch of crooks.
How do you respond to these accusations of corruption and dishonesty?
Unfortunately, there are always going to be people who don't trust the government or the political process. But we have to keep working to regain their trust and prove that we're working for the good of the people.
Good luck with that.
It seems like there's a lot of work to be done to restore public trust in government.
Yes, it's a constant struggle, but we have to keep trying because without the people's trust, we can't effectively govern and make changes for the good of society.
That movie sucked.
Sheep Wars was better.
That guy had a terrible mustache. I think it was great.